A very good morning to everyone. So today we discuss about two important plants which are especially useful in medicinal, right? In a medicine. So today we discuss about two important medicinal uses plants. So first one is commonly we all know that Tulsi, that is Osmum Santum. So here Osmum Santum is a native to India, where it enjoys a religious attachment and like to be grown in shrines and homes as an aromatic perennial shrub. So Tulsi is a part of routine worship and has a scientific background, as the plants possess antimicrobial and antiviral properties and also purifies the air. So it is also grown as a temperate climates. The natural habitat of Tulsi varies from sea level to an altitude of 2000 meters, and it grows naturally in moist soil all over the globe. So commonly you all see in your home or nearby your home, you all find the Tulsi, right? And it is a native to India. This plant is also grown as a pot herb and in a home gardens. Tulsi is cultivated in a semi-urban areas, and the fresh herbage is sold to the temples and worship centers. The major source of Tulsi is from a wild habitat, including uncultivated fields and roadsides actually. And a large volume of herbage is collected during seasons and a trade throughout the country. However, commercial production has a significance due to valuable aroma chemicals extracted from the essential oil of a Tulsi. So here nothing but the chemical which are there in the Tulsi, the chemist. So Tulsi leaves contain a bright yellow volatile oil. So here Tulsi leaves consist of a volatile oil which is useful against insects and bacteria. And the principal constituents of this oil are eugenol and eugenol methyl ido and carsiorol. So this oil is reported to possess antibacterial properties and act as an insecticides. You know, insecticides and pesticides, right? So it inhibits the in vitro growth of Mycobacterium tuberculosis and Micrococcus pyogenes varenicus. So these are the chemical constituent which are present in the leaves oil of a Tulsi leaf. And here the medicinal and different benefits are there in the Tulsi. So Indian mythology attaches a great significance to basil. We can see Tulsi by recognizing it as a holy herb, and perhaps such significance comes from the actual health applications of the herb. So it used in recommended as a first aid in the treatment of respiratory, digestive and a skin disease. Actually it is a first aid treatment, like a first precaution to treat respiratory, digestive and skin diseases. Apart from these common alignments, that is Ayurveda also recognizes its uses for the diseases ranging up to tumors growth. Experimental studies identified to be a highly promising and immunomodulator and a cytoprotective and also anti-cancer agent. So Tulsi can be used in Ayurveda also for the so many medicinal precautions. So next, here some benefits and uses are there of a Tulsi. So first is promotes healthy heart. So holy basil contains vitamin C, actually tulsi contains vitamin C and it is a antioxidants such as I already told it is having eugenol which protects the heart from the harmful effects of a free radicals and eugenol also proves useful in reducing cholesterol level in the blood and anti-aging that is a vitamin C and A. So here vitamin C and A are present and also phytonutrients in tulsi are a great antioxidants and protect the skin from almost all the damages caused by the free radicals and also treats kidney stones. You already heard about kidney stone. Tulsi act as a mild diuretic and a detoxifying agent which helps in lowering the uric acid level in the body and acetic acid present in tulsi helps in the breakdown of the stones and also next useful that is relieves headache. So tulsi is a natural headache reliever which can also relieve migraine pain which occur in a head and fights acne. You know acne nothing but we commonly pimple, right? So tulsi helps kill bacteria and infections. The primary active compound of tulsi oil is a eugenol which helps fight skin related disorder. So osmum xanthan helps treat skin infections both internally and externally, right? It is useful for the skin also, for a glow and for wrinkles, right? So next, relieves fever. Tulsi is an age-old ingredient for treating fever. It is one of the prime ingredients in the formulation of various Ayurvedic medicines and home remedies. And eye health. Tulsi's anti-inflammatory property. Tulsi having an anti-inflammatory property help to promote eye health by preventing viral, bacterial and fungal infection. It also soothes eye inflammation and reduce stress. Next, oral health. Tulsi is a natural mouth refresher. You already know this is a common. It is a mouth refresher and an oral disinfectant. So osmum xanthan can also cure mouth ulcers and destroys the bacteria that are responsible for dental cavities, plaque, right, tartar and bad breath while also protecting the teeth. So here tulsi also protect the teeth and it acts as a oral disinfectant. Next, cures respiratory disorders. So due to the presence of compounds like a campanin, eugenol and a cinnol, tulsi cures viral, bacterial and fungal infections of the respiratory system. It can cure various respiratory disorders like bronchitis and tuberculosis. Rich source of vitamin K. So tulsi is a use for the vitamin K. Is an essential fat soluble vitamin that plays an important role in a bone health and a heart health. That's why it is having rich in vitamin A, K and it is used for a bones and also for a heart health. So here nothing but we discussed about tulsi, that is a osmum xanthan and their medicinal uses. Next we move another important plant which is used as a having a great medicinal value, that is aloe vera, right? So here aloe vera plant has been known and used for centuries for its health, beauty, medicinal and skin care properties. The name aloe vera deserves from the Arabic word olai, meaning shining bitter substance. While vera may, I think it is a Latin word, nothing but true, means in Latin vera means true, and in 2000 years ago the Greek scientist regarded aloe vera as the universal tonic. The Egyptians called aloe the plant of immortality. Today the aloe vera plant has been used for various purposes in dermatology and other field. So the history, how the aloe vera comes. The aloe vera has been used for medicinal purposes in several cultures for a melanina. So it's Greeks, Egypt, Indian, Mexico, Japan and China. Right? Egyptian queens, Nefertiti and Cleopatra used it as a part of their regular beauty. And Alexander Alexander a Great and Christopher Columbus used it to treat soldiers' wounds. The first reference to aloe vera in English was the translation by John Goodway in AD, right, in 1665 AD of a disorders medicinal treats De Materia Medica. By the early 18th, aloe vera was in use as a laxative in the United States. But in the mid-1930s, a turning point occurred when it was successfully used to treat chronic and severe radiation dermatitis. So this is the history of aloe vera and the plant, how the aloe vera plant is. The botanical name of aloe vera is Aloe barbadensis milla. So it belongs to Asphalodaceae family, that is a Liliaceae family, and is a shrubby or a arborescent perennial and xerophytic succulent pea green color plant, and it grows mainly in the dry region of Africa, Asia, Europe and America. So in India it is found in Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and all. So next, anatomy, how the plant. The plant has a rectangular fleshy leaves with serrated edges, yellow tubular flowers and fruits that contain numerous seeds, which leaf is composed of three layers is here. An inner clear gel that contains 99% water and rest is made of glucomans, amino acids, lipids, sterols and vitamins. And the second layer, that is a middle layer of a latex, which is a bitter yellow sap and contains anthraquinones and glycosides. And last, the outer thick layer of a 15 to 20 cells called as a rind, which has a protective function and also synthesizes carbohydrates and proteins. Inside the rind are vascular bundles which are responsible for transportation of substances such as water and starch, like your xylem and phloem tissues. So next, uses here. The medicinal uses of aloe vera. First, it contains a healthful plant compounds like cosmetics. It is used in the cosmetic and pharmaceutical and food industries also use aloe vera extensively. And the plant has an estimated annual market value of $13 billion trusted source globally. Aloe vera is known for its thick, pointed and fleshy green leaves, which may grow to about 12 to 19 inches, that is 30 to 50 centimeters in length. and each leaf contains a slimy tissue that stores water, and this makes the leaves thick. So this water filled tissue is the gel that people associated with aloe vera products, and the gel contains most of the beneficial bioactive compounds in the plant, that is including vitamins, minerals, amino acids and antioxidants. The second, it has an antioxidant and antibacterial property. Antioxidants are important for health, so aloe vera gel contains trusted source powerful antioxidants belonging to a large family of substances known as polyphenols. These polyphenols, along with several other compounds in the aloe vera, helps inhibit the growth of certain bacteria that can cause infections in humans. Aloe vera is known for its antibacterial, antiviral and antiseptic properties. This is a part of why it may help heal wounds and treat skin problems. It accelerates wound healing. So people most often use aloe vera as a topical medicine, rubbing it onto the skin rather than consuming it. In fact, it has a long history of a use in treating sores and particularly burns, including sunburn also. So next, studies suggest that it is an effective topical treatment for a first and second degree burns, for a skin burn or any other burn. For example, here a review of experimental studies that the aloe vera could reduce the healing time of burns by around 9 days compared to conventional medicine. It also helped prevent redness, itching and infections. And the evidence for aloe vera helping heal other types of wound is inconclusive, but the research is promising. So here next use is it reduces dental plaque, so tooth decay and diseases of the gum are very common health problems. One of the best way to prevent these conditions is to reduce the buildup of plaque or a bacterial biofilms on the teeth. So in the mouth rinse of 300 healthy people, researchers compared 100% pure aloe vera juice with the standard mouthwash ingredient chlorhexidine. After 4 days of use, the aloe vera mouth rinse appeared to be just as effective as chlorhexidine in reducing the dental pain. So aloe vera is effective in killing the plaque producing bacteria, that is Streptococcus mutans, in the mouth, as well as the yeast, that is Candida albicans. So here this is the dental cure, and last, it helps to treat cancer sores. So many people experience mouth ulcer or a canker sores at some point in their lives. These usually form underneath the lip inside the mouth and lasts for about a week here. So the studies have shown that aloe vera treatment can accelerate the healing of mouth ulcer. For example, in a 7-day of 180 people with recurrent mouth ulcer, applying an aloe vera patch to the area was effective in reducing the size of a ulcer. However, it did not outperform the conventional ulcer treatment, corticosteroids. In another study, aloe vera gel not only accelerated the healing of mouth ulcer, it also reduced the pain associated with them. So next, it reduces constipation. So aloe vera may also helps to treat constipation. This time, it is the latex, not the gel, that proves the benefits. So the latex is a sticky yellow residue present just under the skin of the leaf. So the key compound responsible for the effect is called aloin or a barbolin, which has a well established laxative effects. So however, people have raised concerns about safety with frequent use. For this reason, aloe latex has not been available in the US as an over-the-counter medication since 2002 trusted source. So contrary to popular belief, aloe vera does not appear to be effective against other digestive conditions such as a irritable bowel syndrome or a inflammatory bowel disease, and it may improve skin and prevent wrinkles. So here there are some preliminary evidences to suggest that tropical aloe vera gel can slow aging of the skin. And in the 2009, of 30 females over the age of 45 taking oral aloe vera gel increased collagen production and improved skin elasticity over a 90 days period, and also suggests that aloe vera could help the skin retain moisture and improve skin integrity, which would benefit dry skin conditions. So here, these are the uses of the aloe vera, right? So here, and so many other uses are there, and you know some other uses of aloe vera or maybe tulsi, right? So today we discuss the medicinal benefits or uses of two important plants. Thank you.